Okay, let's keep moving. So our next challenge here is just to finish, okay, to represent all of the push buttons. We will notice a vast distance between these two, but I think the distance here and here and here are the distances, sorry. There and there and there are similar. So let's just measure what is the distance from here to here. 50, okay. So they will have a spacing of 50 for the next 1, 2, 3 push buttons. And what is the last distance? The spacing of 80 for the last. Okay. So let's go. What does PB2 stand for? PB2 stands for geometry. PB3 will stand for all supports. And PB4 will stand for loading. While PB5 stands for analysis. Okay. Can we cram that? Okay, we have crammed it. Let's go. Okay, so I think it'll be quite easy. We just need to copy all of these. No, sorry, all of these. So here I'll have text geometry. Okay, geometry, and here PB geometry, that's the second one, right? Geometry, and obviously, where is it? My string property here will not be case, it will be geometry, and what else? Come on, it will be geometry, and what else? Okay, the distance. So it will have to be 20 plus 80, or rather, let me just say 80 plus 50. Okay, so it means each time I'm supposed to add 130, except on the last. So 20 plus 130 will have to give me 150 here, and 20 plus 130 will have to give me 150 here. So good, I have geometry. So, but geometry does not fit exactly the whole text, so I think I'll reduce the size of that particular, or should I put 10 everywhere? Let's try and put 10 everywhere to see whether it gives us what we want. Good, okay, so it's better this way. Don't want stress for now. Okay, next we said it was supports, so I will have support here. Support here again, I will have support. So it's just copy paste. Okay, support. Forgotten something? Yes, support. Okay. The distance now, 150 plus 130, that gives me 280, if I'm not confused. 280 and here 280. So let's try that. Good. So the next is load. Should I say loads or loading? What do you choose? Let's say load, right? Okay. Let's say load. So you already have to start computing the next position. Load. And here load. Okay, so on the writing we'll say loading, but in our program we'll use load. Let's see how loading goes. 280 plus 130, what does that give me? I will have 0, then I will have 1. Yes, carry 1. I think it's 410, right? Okay. Oh, not there. 410. 410. Let's try that. Okay, perfect. Loading. Now, what is left is just analysis, right? And the analysis, we've said the distance between loading and analysis is 80, right? So, let's first of all copy for that. We will have text analysis. So analysis will be to launch the calculus, okay? Will be to launch the calculation. Oh, we have a lot of work. Analysis. And here I will say again, analysis. Okay, so the position will be 410 plus 80. That gives me 490. 490 plus 80 gives me 570. Okay, 570. And here 570. Good. So that is it for the push button. I guess we still have some more time here. Yes. Okay. So that is that for the push button. So what can we do next? I think our next thing here, we will just attack. We'll attack this, all of the axes here. Then we'll go back up to the respective panels that are left up there. Okay. Let's just be crazy for now. Okay, so axis one, let me start with axis one. Axis one is meant for 2D modeling, okay? And what are the dimensions? The dimension from here, come on, from here to here. I have 15 in this direction and I have 15 in this other one. Good. What is the height of axis one? I have 700 as height, and what is the width? 1, 2. Okay. So let's go. So already we know by default, by default, the unit of axis in MATLAB is normalized, but we have already changed it, okay, to pixels here. Default axis unit, we have changed it to pixels, so we have no problem for that particular one. So I'll say ax2d to say axis 2d. It is the axis command that is used to do that, and all we need here for now is the position. Okay, we need just the position, and we're measuring from our figure, so we have no problem of parent here, because by default the figure is the parent. We will say 15 following x, 15 following y. The width was 1200 and the height 700. Okay, so let's try to have that. Good. That's the axis. It's just there looking at us, right? If we should try and change the color, then you'll see that it's actually where it's supposed to be. Let's try. Color. Let's put just cyan, for example. Okay, so you see the axis there very clearly, right? Okay, let's maintain it like that for now, just for visibility's sake. Okay, we can change it later on. Then I have a second axis. That's axis 2, which is a reference, right? Where is it? Up here. Coordinate system. So, we'll say cosis, okay? To say coordinate system. So, we'll say axis cosis to be equal to axis. I will need to measure what? The position, okay? The position. So I'd like also try something here. Let's try and see whether we can actually put ax2d as the parent of this axis, so that the position will be measured at 0, 0. Let's just try, okay? So come back here. If I have this axis to be the parent of this other axis, you see that it starts at 0, 0. Okay, so then what is the height? What is the height? I have 150. And what about the breadth? I have 150. Okay. So, it is 150 by 150. Okay. Let me try that. So there is a mistake, okay? So generally here in MATLAB, I think, you can only have panels and UI button groups, plus figures, of course, to be the parents of other widgets, okay? You cannot have a UI control to be the parent of another UI control. You cannot have, I don't think it's possible. That's still to be checked. That's still to be checked. We'll check that. We'll have time, obviously. So I'll need to measure its position from the parent, and from the parent, it gives me 15 and 15. Okay, so that is it right there. Very beautiful. So let's just finish with all the axes before the end of this video. Okay. The next axis, that's axis 3, meant for 3D representation. What is the distance? What is the distance? So, measuring from the origin to, yes, there. I have 1, 2, 3, 5. Okay. I have 1, 2, 3, 5 to be that distance. So, let's go. We have axis 3D to be equal to axis, come on, axis position 1, 2, 3, 5, comma. So I think the height there obviously will be the same height with the other one, 15. And then what is the mama? The width, 550. And what is the height? 300. Okay. So I have 550 by 300. Okay. So let's launch that. Again, I think we should put the color here cyan just for visibility. And then we can cancel all of that later on. Okay, so that's that. So in the next video, we'll continue with our interface. Thank you for watching this one, and see you in the next.